Welcome to the Deep Sky Diary podcast, your guide to photograph the night. My original plan for episode 2 was to cover some of the basic equipment you need for astrophotography. But as I was writing this script, I did not find a good place to start and postponed the topic to the next episode. Right now, I want to tell a small story. It's a story that really happened a few years ago when I started astrophotography. I want to tell this story because I figured it can be quite entertaining, even though the astronomy part falls a bit behind. I have to recite most of this from memory, but I doubt that I will ever forget this. This is what happened in 2018, when I almost got arrested because of astrophotography. This story includes two of my friends from university. I am not sure if they are comfortable with me sharing their names online, so I will replace them with other names. I started researching astrophotography back in 2017, after a conversation in the cafeteria, when my friend Paul told me he wanted to get a new camera. A year later, in the summer, I had some good equipment for astrophotography and wanted to take a nice wide field image of the Milky Way. The problem is my location. Frankfurt and its airport are in my southern skies, not a chance. So Paul and me, we scouted a location on Google Maps, south of Frankfurt, where we would be able to get some dark skies. We spotted a field in the middle of nowhere and decided to spend a night there, with telescopes, cameras and warm clothes. We were accompanied by our friend Daniel, who is also an astronomy enthusiast. I packed all of my equipment in the car and drove about an hour to the location. Paul and Daniel lived on the other side of Frankfurt, they had their own cars. In the evening, we found ourselves in a small parking lot, right on the edge of a forest. In the middle of nowhere, there was not a living soul to be seen. The field where we wanted to set up was apparently behind a small patch of forest we were facing. We found a beaten out track that was accessible by car. After some discussion, we drove our two cars into the forest along the track. Paul and Daniel in the front, me right behind them. And as we entered the forest by car, I saw a sign standing on the side which read Natural Reserve Area. This is the part where Luke Skywalker goes, "I have a bad feeling about this." We drove through the forest and sure enough found ourselves on the field we were looking for. It was quite a big field, surrounded on all sides by forest, with a few tracks running through it. Paul and Daniel stopped the car in the center of the field, right by the track. I looked around and decided to drive to the end of the field to maybe find a better position to set up the camera and telescope, and spot a car standing at the edge of the forest. There was no person to be seen and the car was completely dark. A strange sight, I thought, but I returned to Paul and Daniel. We waited about an hour for the sky to get dark and spent the time talking about all sorts of things. Three dudes, in the dark, in the middle of a field, in the middle of a forest, in the middle of nowhere. We stood there, in the dark, with our headlamps and wanted to set up when this happened. From the track where we entered the field, there was a car approaching, very slowly. And even though it was completely dark, the car's headlights were off. Simultaneously, there was a second car approaching, very slowly, from the other side, the car I had seen before, also without any light. It was quite a scary situation, seeing these two cars slowly rolling towards us from both sides, in the dark, but with no light, with no sound but the engine noise. While us three, we just stood there, next to our cars, and didn't know what was going to happen. The cars stopped about 5 meters away from us. and after a few seconds, they both, at the same instant, switched on their headlights and completely blinded us. It was at this point where I thought, ah crap, this means big trouble. The door of the car in front of us opened and a man walked towards us. I am not able to recall the entire conversation we had, but here is what happened. Apparently, we not only entered a natural reserve area by car, but also an active hunting ground. And the man standing in front of us, kindly informing us that the police is already on its way, was the ranger. But, and I was very glad about that, the situation was cleared up quite quickly. We explained why we were there and also delivered proof by showing him and his partner the gear in our cars. We found common ground quite fast, but I remember this one conversation. The ranger looks at me and is like, "Do I know you? You seem familiar to me." I reply, "No, sir, I have never been here before." After some discussion, I showed him my ID. Apparently, he mistook me for some local troublemaker they were both looking for. Because, you know, my face looks like that. The entire situation is cleared up quickly. We assured them we will not drive into a natural reserve area again and were escorted out of the forest, but in our own cars, luckily. They released us in the small parking lot with only a stern warning. Yeah. And what would you do after such a scary encounter, when you think that you've had enough troubles for one day? You drive a few kilometers, stop by the street, and still try to get that Milky Way shot. Even though it was very scary at the time, looking back I can laugh about this whole story. It's what happens when you mess up the first and most important step in astrophotography: proper planning. I hope you enjoyed this small story from my past. In the next episode, I will start to explain some basics of astrophotography, the reason why you are here in the first place. You can join my work on social media, where I share my images, videos, tips and tricks in equipment, processing, everything astrophotography. You can leave suggestions for future episodes in the comments or on social media. If you have specific questions you want answered in future episodes, leave them after the hashtag DSDQ, a deep sky diary question. My motto is "May the night be with us." It has to be, for the darker the night, the brighter the stars.